Today I'm looking at the LEGO Technic all-terrain vehicle, set 42139. This is one of the newer Technic sets currently available. This model looks like it has some nice features, including suspension on all six wheels, a two-cylinder engine, two-speed gearbox, winch, and a tilt tray. It also includes a chainsaw and logs to throw in the back. So let's open this up and see what's inside. As you can see, we get numbered bags to correspond with the stages of the build, six nice rubbery tyres, sticker sheet, and some fairly hefty building instructions. In all, we have 764 pieces. The instructions contain 245 steps across 155 pages. It is certainly a much thicker book than I was expecting. So let's open up these bags and get building. That took about 3 hours to build. I had a few steps I had to redo. While building this model, make sure you pay special attention to where the winch cable is sitting at each step in the instruction book. Otherwise, you'll be like me, having to remove parts to get it back in the right spot. The chainsaw is a nice little addition. You can spin the chain on it. Just don't lose any of those links. The winch cable is released by pushing down this lever and wound in by turning this gear. It works well enough for what it is. The tipper has a smooth and simple operation. The tailgate is stiff enough to stop the logs and chainsaw falling out. The bed lifts nice and high to drop the load out when the tailgate is open. As you can see, the small wheels and suspension are struggling with these rocks. Perhaps these rocks are too big for these wheels, so let's try it over some smoother terrain. Okay, that wasn't a very fair test, but the suspension really is less than what I hoped for. The beam axle suspension on this model pivots on a fixed point in the center, meaning that for a wheel on one side to go up over an object, some other wheels are going to lose contact with the ground. You might get away with this sort of suspension on a four-wheel vehicle, but when you add that extra axle, it becomes a problem. The highlight of this model is really all the moving parts hidden below in the drivetrain. The two-speed gearbox is a nice simple design, and the gearing is numbered correctly, resulting in a slower engine speed in second gear compared to the faster engine speed in first gear when travelling at the same speed, as can be seen by the movement of the two pistons. The drivetrain continues to both the rear wheels. Each axle has a differential, allowing opposite wheels to turn at different rates. However, the two axles are effectively locked to each other. There is no differential between the two axles. Overall, I think this model had some good and bad points. This model includes a half-decent drivetrain with a lot of moving parts and a good list of functions, some of which could be improved. If you can pick this setup for a good price, it will provide some good additional components for your Technic collection. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to see more like it, give me a thumbs up and subscribe.